Okay, we are in chapter 19, Fourier series. And the first section is some general properties. So basically, Fourier series is to use sine or cosine as orthonormal basis to expand function into a discrete series. Or equivalently, you can express a sine and cosine into exponential function with complex argument. So this is basically the easiest case to expand function using orthonormal basis. In chapter 8 about the Stern Liouville theory, we talk about that we can use eigenfunction of second order self-adjoint ODE to form orthonormal basis, and that those basis function can be used to expand function. Okay, so and sine and cosines are eigenfunctions of second order simple harmonic oscillator equations, which is basically you can think of it as the simplest case for the self-adjoint second order ODE. So basically, Fourier series is the kind of the simplest case that you can do to expand function using eigenfunction of self-adjoint equation. Okay, so the simple harmonic oscillator equation is simple, so you can write it like in this form, like your textbook. So it's second order equation d squared y dx squared. With a negative sign, you can put the eigenvalue to the right-hand side and lambda times y. Okay, so basically this is the simplest eigenvalue, eigenfunction, eigenvalue equation you can think of. And now the basis, the form of the basis depends on your range, your domain of x. And we can start with a domain x is from 0 to 2 pi, just a 2 pi periodic range of x. And you can shift it to any periodic range, so like minus pi to pi, but that's the starting point, and that will that domain, this domain of the eigenvalue problem will determine the normalization constant and the form of the eigenfunction, eigenvalues. So basically, if you use that, and for this domain, you solve this eigenvalue problem, and if you express that those are in sine and cosine, the real function, then the eigenfunction will be like cosine n times x, or sine n times x. And so n, in this case, n will be 1, 2, 3, all the positive integer. And you can actually include n equals 0 too, but the normalization for n equals 0 is a little different. So for the cosine function, n not equal to 0, the normalization is determined. You square this function and integrate over this domain. You square this function, integrate over this domain, you'll get pi out. So in order to get to be normalized, you divide by 1 over square root of pi. So that is the normalization for n not equals to 0. For n equals 0, this is just 1. And integrate over 2 pi will give you 2 pi, so you need to divide it by 1 over square root of 2 pi instead of just 1 over square root of pi. This is for n equals to 0. Okay, and likewise for the sine function, we have 1 over square root sine n x. Now n is only one positive integer because n zero, this is zero, so this doesn't give you anything new. So these are, this can be used as the basis function, and if you define this way, this is already orthonormal. And likewise, you can use exponential function and change those cosine and sine functions into exponential function using the Euler's relation. So like a cosine nx equals to 1 over 2 e to the I n x plus e to the minus I n x, and then the sine n x equals to 1 over 2 i e to the n x minus e to the minus I n x. Okay, now you can change those cosine sine to exponential function, but now your n can be, n is positive, but then you have the negative exponential, negative I n x, so you can change the range of n instead of positive integer to the whole range of integer including zero. So that's the two ways to write down the Fourier series. Now using these bases, we can write down the Fourier series that in your textbook is in the form is in equation 19.1. So 19.1 will give you the expansion. So you have fx equal to all the bases. So you write with it as 1 over a c over 2 plus sum over n from 1 to infinity a sub n cosine nx plus b sub n sine nx. Okay, and the zero term is separate and writing at ac over 2 so that all the a can be found by the same single formula a sub n equals to integrate 0 to 2 pi and divided by 1 over pi fx times cosine n x dx. So n can be 0 to positive infinity for all the integer n here. So likewise, bn is 1 over pi integrate 0 to 2 pi x sine n x dx. Okay, and so this defined expansion of a function fx, and how you found the expansion coefficients a sub n and b sub n using these two formula. Okay, and then you can use this to convert the to exponential function, the expansion using exponential function by these two Euler relation. So you can substitute the cosine and sine into the formula. So what you get is fx is, you keep the constant term the same, then sum over a n from 1 to infinity a n cosine becomes 1/2 of e to the I n x plus e to the minus I n x. Okay, and then plus b n divided by 2 I e to the I n x I x minus e to the minus I x. Okay. All right, so, and now you have the term e to the inx in both multiplied by an and bn, and then you have e to the minus inx in two terms. You can group them together, and those are e to the minus inx. You can extend that to e to the inx, but the change the range of the summation index from negative infinity to infinity and including the zero term and write it like this summation n from negative infinity to infinity c sub n e to the I x I n x. This is in I n x. Okay, so then you can compare this with this form. This form with this form, you pretty sure that n is equal to zero, c zero is simply a zero over two, and then for positive n. So for positive n, it basically an over 2 plus bn over 2i, or change this to minus I bn over 2. So it's given by 1 half an minus I bn for n greater than 0. And for negative n, then you change this term because you have a negative sign here, basically. All you need to change is an plus I bn for n less than 0. Okay, so once you use that and substitute into here, you get basically get back to the cosine, sine, and cosine function. And the cn coefficient can be obtained by just like this two formula, a sub n and b sub n. Now you combine the two and convince yourself that this is 1 over 2 pi integrate from 0 to 2 pi f x e to the minus I n x dx. Okay, so this is the correct formula for getting the coefficient in the Fourier series with compact function, compact exponential function. Okay. And then using that, likewise, you can write down the completeness condition for using exponential function also. Okay, so these are the basic formula for Fourier expansion. And of course, the domain doesn't have to be from 0 to 2 pi. You can actually do it for arbitrary domain, say like if the domain is there from 0 to 2 pi, you have 0 to 2L, or likewise minus L to L. If you do that, then basically you just basically renormalize your x to a normalized x to when the box is 0 to 2 pi and use the same formula, or you can include L in the formula. In this case, then fx will be the formula will change to say from 1 to infinity. So an, and now cosine instead of nx becomes n pi x over L. Okay, and then bn will be the sign will be likewise n pi x over L. So basically you normalize instead of the domain is minus pi to pi is minus L to L. So basically you change x equals to L, you go get back to the old formula. Okay, and then the formula for all this is likewise changed. So let me write here. So a sub n will be instead of 1 over pi, will be 1 over L, 0 to, or minus L to L, because you don't need define like that, so fx cosine n pi x of L dx, and bn will be 1 over L integrate from minus L to L fx sine n pi x over L dx. So these two will be the formula for finding the coefficient to expand the function in a domain minus L to L. Okay, so then the other part of the formula, the section 19.1 will have some examples and a discussion about integrating the Fourier series and taking the derivative over the of the Fourier series, and so we'll do that, continue to do that next time.